Welcome back. You're watching News Tonight. In some news from the state, a delegation of CPM leaders today called on Chief Minister M. Karunanidhi and demanded to resolve the issues of people living in temple lands. The leaders of the left submitted a memorandum to the Chief Minister which said that more than 3 lakh families across the city are living in lands owned by various temples for many decades, and the previous government has charged excess arrears, an amount which the poor people are unable to pay. The party leaders urged Chief Minister to appoint a committee to look into the issue. And just last month, the party had staged a day-long hunger strike in Chennai over the issue. In some national news, yet another encounter with the Naxals. Government forces have killed at least 10 Naxalite guerrillas in Kurtpur district in Orissa. The guerrilla were killed in a heavy exchange of gunfire with paramilitary troops. The offensive follows the Naxal rebels on Saturday set off a blast which killed 8 government troops. Troops were part of a supply line that delivered ration to forces engaged in operations against the rebels. In April, the rebels had killed 76 government troops in a single ambush in Dantewada, the worst setback in the fight to crush the communist insurgency. Now, after the case of the orphaned child Rajita in Andhra Pradesh shocked the nation, the Mehboob Nagar District Police have zeroed in on the orphanage in charge and the so-called foster parents whose alleged callous actions pushed orphaned Rajita to the brink. Cases are being pursued against them even as Rajita awaits justice in a hospital bed. One ray of hope is that many NDTV viewers have come forward to help the child. Uma Sudhir reports from Mehboob Nagar.
This is the man accused of running an illegal orphanage in Mehboob Nagar district of Andhra Pradesh, and with him is the couple to whom he handed over 8-year-old orphan child Rajita. Till June 2009, Premnath reportedly had 63 children with him, and Rajita was among the last 3 children he gave away because he no longer got financial support from the government.
వీళ్ళు ఏమో చేసినట్టు వేస్తే చేసినారు మేడం అది తప్పు కదా హ్యుమానిటర్ అంటే మనిషికి మానవత్వం ఉండకూడదా ఇప్పుడు అమ్మాయి ఎవరో దొరుకుతుంది అమ్మాయిని మనం ప్రాసెస్ ఎంత అవుతుంది ఇట్లా మనం తీసుకొని వచ్చి మన హోమ్లో పెట్టుకోవాలి మనం ఏమైనా చేయాలనుకుంటే అంతవరకు ఎక్కడ ఉండాలి ఎవరు కస్టడీలో ఉండాలి ఎక్కడ ఉండాలి ఇప్పుడు ఐసీడీఎస్కు సంబంధించి ఏమో 5 ఇయర్స్ అంటుంది మిగతా ఏజ్ గ్రూప్ వాళ్ళంతా 6, 7, 8 ఎక్కడ పోవాలి
ఆడపిల్లకు సేవ చేద్దామని మేము తీసుకున్నాం కానీ ఇంత పెద్ద కదా మేము అనుకోండి ఎవరన్నా ఆడపిల్లకు అన్యాయం చేయను తీసుకుంటారా ఒక పిల్లను ఒక వేరే కన్ను ఉన్న పిల్లని తెచ్చి అక్కడికి సాయం చేద్దామని చెప్తా అనుకున్నా కానీ ఇది ఇట్లా ఇంత పెద్ద అయితే మేము అనుకోండి
The police has registered cases under the Child Labour Prevention Act and for child abuse.
Any person who runs an orphanage, he has to have a certificate to run an orphanage. When he was holding 3 girls, 2 girls and 1 boy in that particular orphanage, and he doesn't have a certification to run an orphanage.
At the government hospital where Rajita arrived seriously malnourished and bruised more than 3 weeks ago, the child is waiting to go to a place she can call home.
In the last 15 minutes that I've been here, Rajita has asked me at least 3 times to take her away with me. Very touching to see how this child reacts to a little warmth and affection.
Child is improving with a good diet and antibiotics and anti-tuberculosis drugs. We are taking better care in this hospital.
Several NDTV viewers have offered help and support to Rajita, hoping to correct the many wrongs in her life so Rajita can at least from now live the life she deserves. With Uma Sudhir in Mehboob Nagar, in New Delhi, Suprita Das for NDTV.
Moving on, today is the 150th birth anniversary of Rabindranath Tagore, an event that the country will celebrate over the next 12 months. The Nobel laureate was not a great student and hated being confined in a classroom. He changed schools 4 times and each stay was brief, to say the least, and he never matriculated. Well, but it's quite another matter that later, Oxford University came down to Shantiniketan to award him a doctorate.
The Oriental Seminary in Kolkata. Tagore's first school. He had thrown a tantrum to be allowed to go to school when he was 7 in 1868. But he left in a month, taking with him a memory of the kind of punishment doled out there. A boy who was unable to repeat his lessons, he writes in his reminiscences, was made to stand on a bench with arms extended, and on his upturned palms were piled a number of slates.
এই চার দেওয়ালের গণ্ডির মধ্যে শিক্ষা লাভ করাটা ওনার হয়তো ধাতে সহ্য হয়নি
Tagore's memory of St. Xavier's School which he joined in 1876 for about 6 months, was also bleak. But for one teacher, one Father D. Penaranda, who one day noticed he was not writing his paper, put his hand on his shoulder and asked him, "Are you not well, Tagore?" It was a simple question, Tagore writes, but one that I have never been able to forget.
He kept his relationship with St. Xavier's for a long time. One is in 1927, he came to St. Xavier's and gave a gift to St. Xavier's. The gift was the statue of Jesus Christ.
So did Tagore lose out because he never managed to get himself a formal education?
If Rabindranath had a formal education, he could at best become an ICS or something like that. That would have been a great loss for our country and for the world for that matter, I think. So I think it's a blessing in disguise that Rabindranath didn't have formal education.
In 1940, 27 years after he got the Nobel Prize, Oxford University came down to Shantiniketan and gave Tagore an honorary doctorate. In Kolkata, with G.D. Shankar, Monideepa Banerjee, NDTV.
After this break, what are the latest features in the Mercedes? Find out more on the other side.